Okay.
Hi.
Live stream.
I'm Randy. This is Tal. We're Bachman and Bachman.
We're coming to you from a secret location.
We're stranded on an island, and we are stranded.
It's the island kingdom of Bachmania.
So if you're stranded and watching us, we do this all the time at family dinners and Christmas and things like that. We just play all of our favorite songs. Some are Eagles, some are Beatles. They're unrehearsed. They're going to be full of mistakes.
Yeah,
we're going to show you how human we are, and you can sing along with us.
And let's dedicate this to all of the cover band musicians out there who are so much better at playing all of these songs than we will be.
Exactly.
So lazy.
We sound exactly like the bands.
We just haven't bothered to learn these songs properly.
Yeah, here we go. Here's one of my favorites. I'm going to sing this. I've never sung it before. It's an Eagles song. I love Glenn Frey. And I know Jack Tamption, who wrote the song with him, so we're going to do this song. You want to get the lyrics on your phone? It's called Take It Easy. Get them and sing along. Ready, Tal?
Yeah.
Well, I'm riding down the road trying to loosen my load. I got seven women on my mind. Four that want to own me, two that want to stone me. One says she's a friend of mine. Take it easy.
Technically do that again, but it's live, so we can't.
Okay.
It's just like the old days.
Everything will be faster.
Yeah.
And we've got cheat lyrics here because we don't really know these songs.
Right. That's how, yeah.
Okay, this summer, as a father, I blew my brains out. I bought tickets for about 14 or 15 or 18 of us.
Yeah.
For McCartney, Queen, ELO, Jeff Lynne's ELO, and Dido. And they were all phenomenal shows. We saw them all within 10 days in June. And it was really great to be there with me, with my kids, and my grandkids. If you have a chance to go and see somebody, go and see them. The world is changing. You might never see them again. We love Jeff Lynne, ELO. He did a great thing for Tal earlier in Tal's career.
Mm-hmm.
We were recording in White Rock in our little shed. And I had given Jeff Lynne Tal's solo tape. This is before She's So High. At a Ringo Starr party in Beverly Hills, I was playing with Ringo Starr's band. Gave Jeff Lynne a tape. We're out in the shed in our front yard in White Rock, and the phone rings. I had a long, long phone line that was probably 100 feet long. It's before they had cell phones. And the phone rings. And I say, talent's for you. And he says, who is it? And I said, it's Uncle Jeff. And he just gets the phone. He says, hello. And actually, he fell down. He slid on the ground like, Jeff Lynn called me. And after that, Jeff Lynn sent the mobile spaceship, the ELO thing, a medal, like ELO medal and all kind of stuff for Tal.
Well, I got that from the ELO fan club when I was a kid.
Yeah, Jeff Lynn. Oh, did you?
Yeah. No, I was, sorry, I was a member of the ELO fan club. But in my mind, he sent it all to me.
In my mind, I thought that's what happened.
Yeah. Well, the ELO was my favorite first band, right, of my own, right? So we're going to do an ELO song right now.
What key were you in?
A minor. Jeff, I want to dedicate that one to my friend Liz.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Liz, that's for you. Liz. When do I meet Liz? Where does Liz live?
Ontario, yeah.
Oh, have I met her? She's the blonde?
No. I don't think you've met Liz.
Okay. Trying to do what Neil Young does here. I try to put this in the neck thing and play it. I need to practice this. So I'm just going to do Heart of Gold.
Are you just going to hold it in your hand?
Yeah, I'm going to play guitar and then... Ready?
Thank you. up into Hollywood, up into Redwood, across the ocean for a heart of gold. I've been in my mind, it's such a fine line that keeps me searching for a heart of gold. And I'm getting home. Keep me searching for a heart of gold. And I'm getting
my Winnipeg friend, Mr. Neil Young.
We should tell a little story about when we recorded with Neil.
We recorded with Neil in his Broken Arrow Ranch?
Yes, in a big old barn, not soundproofed. And we were recording live, and this is honestly true. It was not soundproof, so there was farm animals right outside the barn. And so before every take, the roadies would have to run out and shoo away all of the sheep and geese so that we wouldn't get leakage into the microphones.
And usually in a recording studio, you have a big thing called baffles that baffle your sound.
Yeah.
And his was bales of, bales of hay, which weigh about 120 pounds each, you know, with rope around. So you move these baffles. And then for reflection, they had big rocks or sheets of plywood. And we kept waiting and waiting for Neil to come. And he was late. And he was hardly ever late.
Right.
And then we heard he was there. We went running outside of this barn. He was recording in his barn. And he showed up and he had on sweatpants. They were all ripped open and he was bleeding in the leg and his shirt was ripped. I said, what happened? He said,
I was like Jack Nicholson on The Shining.
He said, I was hang gliding and I crashed. And I goes, well, are you okay? He said, no, let's rock. And we went in and he put on a guitar and we recorded the song. So thank you, Neil. Neil's been a friend of mine since we were teenagers in Winnipeg. Okay, a story.
Neil walked in like a cross between Jack Nicholson on The Shining, Jim off of Taxi, and Yoda, right?
And Mr. Cool. I mean, what guy falls out of the sky, crashes, and comes in and says, let's rock?
That was a wonderful day. So I'm going to try playing this fretless
bass.
Oh, cool.
Tal just got this bass. It's really cool.
I got this yesterday.
Cool.
I bought it off a guy a couple hundred bucks. It's used. It's fretless. I'm not really a bass player, let alone a fretless bass player, but we'll see what we can do here.
Okay, this is a Mose Allison song. I'm really big fan of Mose Allison's. Burton Cummings and I discovered Mose Allison, who basically wrote, because we discovered Georgie Fame first, and found that Georgie Fame was doing a lot of Mose Allison songs, really cool songs with incredibly intellectually humorous lyrics. Here's one that is kind of like American Woman, that every 4 or 5 years it becomes relevant again. This is very relevant, this song. Mose Allison's song called Everybody's Crying Mercy. I don't believe the things I'm seeing. I can't believe the things I've heard. Everybody's crying mercy, but they don't know the meaning of the word. It's a bad luck situation, and every day it gets a little worse. Politicians say they want justice, just as soon as they do their business first. Touch and go, toe to toe, jump aboard for the ride. Straight ahead, baby, knock him dead. Give a cheer and choose your souvenir. The spin doctors keep talking in circles. They don't know what we're headed for. President says he wants peace on Earth just as soon as he wins the war. Touch and go, toe to toe. Choose your side and jump aboard for the ride. Straight ahead, baby, knock him dead. Give a cheer and choose your souvenir. Spin doctors keep talking in circles. They don't know what we're headed for. President says he wants peace on Earth just as soon as he wins the war. Can you tell me what we're fighting for? Just as soon as he wins this war. Hope you could hear that bass. It was pretty cool.
Yeah, I hope you could, yeah. Or maybe not. There's a few mistakes in there.
Everybody crying mercy. Mose Allison. Here we are live, Bachman and Bachman, the oldest of the twins, me and my twin brother Tal. He wasn't born 2.5 minutes after me. He was born 25 years after me. Okay, are you gonna do this?
Do some Beatles.
What key is this? Am I doing this?
Just, I don't know.
Well, let's both do it.
Let's just do it.
Okay.
A?
Yeah. And the reason I did that is I just thought I stole that from John Lennon. Taking Care of Business goes. And Beatles go, Get Back. So there's my confession of where I got that from.
The apocalypse has given us a kind of freedom to talk about all the things we've stolen over the years. So yeah, it doesn't matter anymore.
Nobody can sue us.
It doesn't matter. You know?
They won't even take money in the grocery store. I went in the stores.
They won't enjoy this.
They won't touch money.
Yeah, who cares? You know what?
And by the way, all the computers are getting overloaded. Italy, like, internet's shutting down.
Well,
we hope you're safe and got food and toilet paper.
Yes, that is true. And look, I'm going to need that in 1 sec. But you should do that.
Looking out?
Yeah, number one.
Oh, okay.
So somebody asked me the other day what my favorite song was of yours.
Yeah.
And somebody else asked me to ask you what one of my favorite songs was. I don't know if you know any of my songs. But anyway, but I said Looking Out for Number One's best BTO song.
Yeah.
Well, let's do it.
Okay, I'll just tell where this came from.
Yeah.
I was a very young kid in Winnipeg trying to play guitar. And I made friends with a really incredible guy who was a year older than me. His name was Lenny Bro. Lenny, LennyBreau. Google that, you will be amazed. One of the world's greatest guitar players. And he had started playing guitar when he was 5. When I met him, he was 16 and I was 15. And by then he could play all Chet Atkins, all Merle Travis, all Scotty Moore, all the rock and roll stuff that was out, and a lot of jazz stuff. And I had no tape recorder or anything, so I was just going, whatever I could remember that he showed me, I would remember. I had no way to write it down, couldn't write music. And I wanted to have him show me these jazz endings called codas. So every end of a jazz song will have a coda that they all play. And sometimes they put that in the middle and they solo over it. So I took these two endings that he showed me and thought, what a unique way to write a song. So one ending went. The other ending went. Which Ray Charles used in a song called This Little Girl of Mine. So I took those two and put them together. I went to Lenny Bro a couple of years later, actually, and said, hey, I'm in a band called BTO, and we have a number one song called You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet. And those jazz endings that you showed me, I wrote a song out of them. He said, what do you mean? I said, well, I took one ending and made it the verses, and I took the other ending and made it the choruses. And he said, yeah, but when you play the song, people will think, it's an ending. It's over. He was a real hip guy beating that guy. Here's the two endings. Okay, you ready? You're gonna.
Yeah, song.
One. Yeah. Every day is an endless train. You've got to ride it to the end of the line. Troubleshoot or blow the bad luck away, then you will make it to your station on time. And you'll find out every trick in the book, and that there's only one way to get things done. You'll find out the only way to the top is looking out for number one. I mean, you keep looking out for number one. every trick in the book, and there's only one way to get things done. We're speeding up. The only way to talk is looking out for number one. I mean, you keep looking out for number one. Well, that's us. We're looking out for number. Big ending. Number one, number one, number one.
Dog dropped my stick.
Yeah. Oh.
Thank you to Wayne's World for this format, by the way, to Dana Carvey and who was the other guy? Oh, Mike Myers. Sorry, Mike. Hey, Mike, thanks for putting American Woman in Austin Powers. I love that. Here we are. Oh, we're going to do some... hey, when we were in London, I love these guys. Took Tal to see them at the World's Fair. We're Expo in Vancouver, outside Gypsy Kings.
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
Long time ago. And then we went to see them at the Commodore.
Not, yeah, but that's not them, though.
I know, but I'm just talking about the music.
Okay.
Maybe they'll do this.
Okay.
We also saw Los Lobos. So two of our favorite bands are Los Lobos and Gypsy King, just because of the rhythm and stuff. Tal has spent some time in Argentina. And now he's going to do this song, and I'm going to try to play along and mess it up.
Yeah.
Is this a Mexican wedding song?
Yes, this is a Mexican love song. I learned it off a Los Lobos record.
Oh, cool.
And one of the great moments of my life was seeing the Los Lobos years ago at the Commodore.
Yeah.
It was a raucous, good time.
I was there.
They played
you.
This song, and maybe I should do a quick rough translation. This is a song called Anselmo.
Oh, the translation is incredible.
Dad doesn't know the song. He's going to just try to follow along. But really quick, just in case anyone's interested, Anselmo, it's a rough translation. When you get married to the other guy, and when they ask, I will instantly oppose the marriage. And if the priest asks why I oppose the marriage, I'll tell him that it's because you're my lover. You're my love. And if the guy who you were going to get married to gets married, I will whip out my firearm and start shooting. Because at the end of the day...
This is a Mexican wedding love song.
This is a love song. At the end of the day, I don't fear death, and I'm going to the boat. I think that's an idiom. Like, I'll go to the wall because here I am the authority. And then there's the chorus. Anselmo, Anselmo, Anselmo. Chaparra is like a little... It kind of means like my little sweetie, a little hottie, a little short.
Okay, let's do
it. Well, wait. We got to do the next one. Really, okay.
Oh, great.
If you refuse to marry me, I will take away the ranch and property of your father. I will slap taxes or fines on it and burn down the house because for some reason I am here, the authority. And I command in this municipality, and I'm telling you that in case you ever want to escape. This is horrible, right?
Terrible.
This is Latino. Okay. And in the municipality next door, my uncle Eligio is in charge, so all I have to do is tell him that you've tried to escape and he'll arrest you.
Okay.
I mean, it's just, you know, it's
horrible.
I don't
see the world the word pistolero in there.
Well,
is that guy?
It's it's cohete.
Okay. You're ahead. You lead us through this.
Tu boda, cuando pregunten enseguida me opondré. Y si pregunta el cora por qué me opongo, yo le diré que porque tú eres mi querer. Y si se enoja el que iba a ser tu esposo, saco mi cohete y me pongo a disparar. Al fin y al cabo yo no le temo la muerte y voy al bote porque soy la autoridad. Ay, Anselmo, 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 chaparra de mis penares. O dejas que te visite, o te mando los gendarmes. reviso y te tiene que agarrar. Ay, Anselma, 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 chaparra de mis penares, o dejas que te visite, o te mando los gendarmes.
All right.
Not bad.
Buenísimo.
Notice me singing along.
All right,
singing
that's
along,
dedicado
then?
To mis amigos in Puerto Rico,
great.
Mexico, and Costa Rica y Argentina.
Great. Hey, a few years ago, I got a way back when BTO hit number one in the mid-70s with You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet in our album. We were asked to tour, we toured England, actually we toured the world, but our opening act in England was Thin Lizzy. And I loved Phil Lynott, the bass player. Very tall, black Irishman guy, great looking guy, tall like Hendrix, great hair, great skin, earrings, bandanas. He dressed like Hendrix, he was very cool. And this was the big song, The Boys Are Back in Town. So after he passed away, I got a call from his mother, a contact, saying, we're doing a Thin Lizzy tribute album. Would I do a song? And so like an idiot, I said, only if I could do The Boys Are Back in Town. And they said, okay, because nobody else wants to do that. Because sometimes you can't do a song
right.
better than the original. It's just etched right. in everybody's mind. And you, whatever you do, it can't be any better. So I thought, I'll just take this and totally dissect it and do it my own sloppy kind of way and honor it as a song and honor Phil Lynott as a songwriter. So I did it in kind of in this style. You going to play guitar or bass?
I can try playing bass.
Doesn't matter.
I don't know what the chord is.
We're just kind of winging this. Two, three, four. Guess who just got back today? The wild-eyed boy that had been away. Haven't changed much, haven't got much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy. They're asking if you had been around, how you were doing, where you could be found. Told them you were living way downtown, driving the old men crazy. The boys are back in town, boys are back in town. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. Now, the boys are back, the boys are back in town. The boys are back, the boys are back in town. She'd be on the porch just shaking what she's got. Man, I tell you, she was cool, she was red hot. That mean that chick was steaming. That time over at Johnny's place, chick got up and she just slapped Johnny's face. Man, we just fell all about the place. That chick don't want to know, forget her. The boys are back in town. The boys are back. Boys are back in town. Boys are back in town. The boys are back in town. Boys are back in town. The boys are back in town. Boys are back in town. Now we sing. Will spill. boys want to fight, you better let them. Jukebox in the corner blasting out my favorite song. The nights are getting warmer and it won't be long. It won't be long till summer comes. Now that the boys are back again. Cause the boys are back in town. 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 The boys are back. The boys are back in town. Thin Lizzy.
Wow. You know, you really get an appreciation for frets trying to play these things.
Oh, I know.
Interesting. Okay.
Oh, good. Now Tal's going to do the lead on this one.
Well, you know, everybody likes this song and what's yeah. not to like. So I thought I would do it.
Good.
I wanna start something new, and it's breaking my heart you're leaving. Baby, I'm grieving. But if you wanna leave, take good care. Hope you have a lot of nice things to wear. But then a lot of nice things turn bad out there. Ooh, baby, baby, it's a wild world. It's hard to get by. A bad girl, but if you want to leave, take good care. Hope you make a lot of nice friends out there. But just remember, there's a lot of bad anywhere. Ooh, ooh, baby, baby, it's a wild world. It's hard to get by.
I met Cat Stevens once. Oh, I met him twice. I met him once in L.A. He was in the elevator of the L'Hermitage Hotel, the Dorp, and I said, hi, Cat. I'd met him before in England. He was wearing blue jean top, blue jean bottom. He's quite a smaller guy compared to me. And I saw him a week later, and he was wearing white. And I said, hi, Cat. And he said, my name's not Cat anymore. It's Yousef. And in that period of time, he had gone surfing or swimming, dragged into the ocean by a riptide, and said, if you save me, I'll dedicate my life to you. And he was thrown up on the beach. He changed his name. He stopped singing and kind of retired. And I saw him in that period of time. It was quite amazing. And I loved his songs. I mean, he wrote a couple of great songs before he had his own hits, his own string of hits. And he's come back now in the last couple of years. So welcome back, Yusef.
Yeah, Kat. Started to play again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
The prodigal musical son has come back.
Yes.
And he wrote a lot of good songs. So you're going to do one of your songs.
Oh.
Yeah, Undone.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm changing the key.
Yeah, what key?
Because I can't sing it. Okay. I'm not Burton Cummings. I can't sing this in a high key. So it's like...
Okay, B minor?
B minor. E. It's D.
Okay, I'll see if I can do it.
Okay. Guitar okay. lesson, how to transpose the song.
Yeah,
see how fast this kid is?
It's too late. She's gone too far. She's lost the sun. She's come undone. She didn't know what she was headed for. When I found what she was headed for, it was too late. She's come undone. She found a mountain that was far too when she found out she couldn't fly, it was too late. Too late. She's lost the sun. She's gone too far. She's lost the sun. She's come undone. She wanted truth, but all she got was lies. When it came time to realize, it was too late. She was a special one. We tried to hold her, but she had to run. And now it's too late. It's too late. She's gone too far. She's lost the sun. She's come undone. Too many mountains, not enough hills to climb. Too many churches, but not enough truth. Too many people, but not enough eyes to see. Too many lives to meet, but not enough time. 'Cause too late, gone too far, she's lost the sun. She's come undone.
Way to go.
Unbelievable.
Pretty good. Oh, we're going to do here, flat top.
So we're going to do a couple more.
Yeah. This is a live stream, by the way. We're stranded on an island. Luckily, it's Vancouver Island. It's a big island.
Thank you for joining us.
But they're shutting down, and thanks for joining us. We know you have nothing else to do. And we'll be back. Just keep watching my website, Facebook or UFace or YouTube or whatever.
Right.
And...
You want to answer a few questions?
Yeah, yeah.
I asked it ahead of time.
And we do a radio show called Randy's Vinyl Tap on CBC Radio. And Tal does my mail and my research. And so we get a lot of questions about everything. In fact, on one of these broadcasts, I'll show you how we put together a Vinyl Tap radio show. So what kind of questions you got?
Well, has your hoarding of guitars helped at all during this crisis time?
Yes, I eat a guitar every night.
Does it give you a feeling of comfort at all?
It gives me something to do. You know, in an interview, we were on a cruise ship, Tal and I, with my band, just in February, just before everything shut down. And the woman said, How many guitars do you have? And I looked her in the eye and I said, how many pair of shoes are in your closet? So that was my answer. Mm. The guitars do give me comfort. They were a great investment. I bought Gretsch guitars for about 30 years. Sold them to Fred Gretsch. 385 Gretsch guitars sold to Fred Gretsch for his Gretsch Museum, which is now in Savannah, Georgia. And I sold him 385 Gretsch guitars.
Wow.
And as an investment, I quadrupled my money. Mm. So yes, that does give me great comfort. And I didn't buy it with my normal flow of money. I produced a band called Trooper, and it was only with Trooper's money and my daily per diem, which was a cheapo $6 a day way back then, and then $10 a day. I bought those guitars with my extra money. I'm not a guy who gambles my rent money or the money for my rent or food for my kids. It was my extra money from producing Trooper.
Mm. Okay.
Did that take care of that?
Yeah. Okay. Last question before we play this one. Speaking of a Beatles song, Pam Hooper asks, can you pick one favorite Beatles song?
No.
I think my favorite is Dear Prudence.
Really?
I think if I had to pick one, I'd pick that one.
Well, it's like trying to pick a favorite Eagles song.
Or something. Favorite child.
The minute you start, yeah, the minute you start to play another song, you go, well, this is my favorite song.
Yeah.
That's my favorite song. They're all a favorite song, just like Tal said, which one of your children is your favorite child?
Yeah.
Well, one day, the princess is the princess. The next day, she's the devil.
Yeah.
The prince is
she's
the prince. The
out.
Next day, he's the devil, right? Time out, put him in a padded room. I mean, every kid's different every day. Every song, when I play my own songs, I react to them differently every day. So,
do you have a least favorite Beatles song?
Yeah,
like Revolution Number 9. Is it what? Dear Prudence.
What's your favorite?
No, it's got to be Revolution Number 9 on the White Album. Not the Revolution, it was the single.
There's
the
some that are,
Yoko,
there's
Yoko
some that I think
on.
Are the crazy,
one.
Like Honey Pie, that bing, bing,
yeah,
bing, all that spring bing thing. I don't like that.
Anyway, okay, let's do a Beatles song.
Okay.
I dropped D, by the way. I dropped my D.
Here come old flat top pecan, moving up slowly. Please shoot.
Well,
we're famous for our endings. We just stopped playing. That's the ending.
Oh, man. I hope Paul McCartney never watches that.
He's watching right now. Hello, Paul.
What do you think? Got time for one more, maybe?
One more.
You want to try?
I think I'll follow you on this. I toured with this band, but I never don't remember this song. I think I will once you do it.
All right. Thanks for watching.
Oh, we're in D. Okay.
Yeah, drop D. Thanks for watching, and we hope you're hanging in there. And maybe we'll do another one of these.
We'll do another one.
We have so many songs to do bad versions of.
Yes. It's so great. We don't need to practice or anything.
Right.
We just get together and goof around. You ready? Surprise ending.
Wayne's World. Okay. Bachman's World. Surprise ending. Thanks for joining
us. Thank you all.
Hope you're hanging in there. And maybe we'll do this again.
See you next time.
All right.
Time to go eat some toilet paper. That's all we got.